Educating Investors.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to our man, Al, in Homo Sasa. What's going on, brother?
Isn't it wonderful? I went ahead and invested in your Tiger Dollars, and I went ahead and got the gold report for a year, and also your morning, your call letter and stuff like that, and I got over a 50% return in one day, not counting everything else. But I just want to thank you. Tom's not perfect, but he tells you how to put your stops in, and he keeps your losses small. You can take your small losses, but then all of a sudden you'll be like Babe Ruth, and you'll hit a home run. I mean, a big home run.
Yeah.
And put the money in your pocket.
Okay, I mean, brother. You're awesome, man. Thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Let's take a look at one of our four agreements. Love coming out of you makes you happy. The whole world can love you, but that's not the love that'll make you happy. What will make you happy is to share all the love you have inside of you. That is the love that'll make the difference. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 70, NASDAQ off 348, S&P's off 46, gold contract up $4.90, trading at $17.32 an ounce. We got silver up 20 cents, $26.05 flat. Light sweet crude getting absolutely smoked, down $5. $59.59 a barrel, notes and bonds. We have the 10-year right now, down 24 ticks, trading 131.10. The 30-year off a full point at 154.06. And King Dollar. King Dollar, right, excuse me, folks, up 424 ticks, trading 91.866. The euro is at 119. The yen is at 108.98. And the British pound's at 139 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at it. You got to love it. I love this hour, folks. Bottom line, what are we doing? You hit lows. We're coming right in to test those lows just as I was getting on the air. This is going to get really intriguing because this is what you have. So inside the S&P, you're down 46 bucks. You're at 39.17. 39.13 was the low. 39.13 was established 10 minutes ago. Bottom line, you get a little pop. Now we're coming back down into that level. And if we take a look, this is going to be pretty cool. So if you take a look at this, what you're going to see is that when we came down the first time inside the E-minis, you came down with 70,000 contracts on the 10-minute. Well, this one here, and you're coming down with 47,000. So the bottom line is that you don't have enough juice to basically break out these lows. So this will be intriguing how this is going to basically shake out. The reason being is that this is the test of the low. You're testing with tremendously lighter volume. That is saying you can get some kind of a pop. Now let's go into the NQs, because the NQs have been selling off all day long. We've been talking about the ABC structure on the way up inside of the NQs. We take a look at the NQs right now, and what you have, the NQs, they came in, busted the low. But that being said, now check it out, okay? So the NQs just went down to 12,811. The number is 12,822 that you want to keep your eye on, and this is why. That was 10 minutes ago. That's where we basically hit the first low, and you had volume behind the move. We had 182,000 contracts. Well, we just did, and we rejected, folks. We went down to 125,000 versus the 182,000. That's saying that, guess what? Somehow this thing is going to want to claw itself higher. We'll see how that shakes out, because there's no doubt inside the NQs that you have not had a bid all day long. That being said, we go over to the NQ, to the Qs right now, and this is still in a complex ABC structure. Up, that is. Okay, so what do we have inside the Qs? you get the same setup. It's that the first leg down 10 minutes ago had 2.6 million, and we just did 2.3. So the bottom line, you get 300,000 less. We'll see if this baby can get some action on the way up. Gold. Gold contract out here. Let's take a look at gold. Gold not only caught a bid. 18 GC. We get some big volume here, which is really cool coming into a Friday. So gold contract out here, folks, has done 239,000 contracts. We're up 560. You're trading 1732. Bottom line, this 1777 is game out here. And right now you're at 1732. We got to take a look at the silver contract. Come on, SIJ. Okay, let's take a look at silver. Silver right now is up 26 cents. Wrong contract. I'm going to keep doing this. Sorry, one second, folks. Sorry about this. S-I-K, is it S-I-K? What are we? S-I-H, okay, S-I-H. So, silver contract right now. That's the wrong contract. Bottom line, you're out here at 26.05. 30 bucks is game. That's how the silver contract's shaking out. Let's go to the oil contract. This is something else, man. Oil's down $5. $59. You talk about smoking. I'm not quite sure what the heck happened with this contract. But whatever happened, the crude settles down 7% in the worst route since September. This is quite a route, man. It's like all of a sudden the world has discovered that we have so much oil. It's phenomenal, right? Bottom line is that you give them back in 6.5 hours, you give them back about 2 months. Let's go take a look at a few of the oil equities. You go look at ExxonMobil. ExxonMobil, okay, it's going to be, that's down 239. We take a look at Chevron. This is down 334. More than likely what you're going to see here, you're going to, let's see. So Chevron's got some support up at this 100. Right now you're at 104.63. Would make sense, too. I mean, the run on both of these oils were extraordinary. 4 months ago, you were at $65, and you went all the way up to 112. That's quite a route, though. There's no two ways about that. Okay, notes and bonds. Let's get over to that note and bond market. So 10-year note. You have 2.5 million contracts. Bottom line, you're breaking out the low. You know, we'll see whether they get rejection at a lower price. We have not got it. Yesterday, what we have got is contraction of volume in a monster way. But bottom line is you need a rejection of lower price. And we'll see whether it basically comes out. Today, you're not going to get it today. And then once we do get it, and I do expect we will get it, then you're going to have to get back inside 130, 131, inside the 10. And right now, the 10 is trading out at 130, 111. We get over and we take a look at the 30-year bond. What do you have with the 30-year bond right now? That's down with 577,000 contracts. That's big contract volume. Bottom line, you haven't got a rejection of price either. King Dollar. King Dollar out here. What do we have? Bottom line, King Dollar's come right back topside. Anything of 91,600 is saying that, hey, guess what? King Dollar can go higher. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights Today, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today.
Hey there, I'm Andy Arbertine with Tiger Precious Metals and Stones. Whether you're looking to buy and sell precious metals or trying to find the perfect diamond ring, I'm here to help. I have over 15 years of experience with diamonds and precious metals. You can call me directly at 727-329-8245, and I will personally answer any questions you have and help you find exactly what you're looking for. I will be your personal concierge in the metal and stone business. Give me a call today, 727-329-8245.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 44. You get the Nasdaq off 338, S&P's off 44. Let's go into the NDX. As the NDX, no doubt, as well as the Nasdaq, is getting the beating out here. You got Amgen is putting slight, you know, it's up 0.4%. You get Fox up 0.3%. Other than that, on the downside, you got Mercado Libre down 6%. You get Tesla down 5.5%. Pinduoduo is down 5.5%. LRCX, let's take a look at some of these chip stocks for the Tigers and Tigresses out here. You got Lam Research right now trading down $10 at $5.42. Oh, let's see. So you got a consolidation. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, this isn't a consolidation. This is not only a consolidation, but what you have here is that 481 is the number, if you're looking to get it. This came down hard to 481. You go all the way back to the highs of 600. You come off them again. You get down to 501. Interesting, because 501 was the top of the lows. Well, if you're going to be fishing here, it's going to be the 506 to 481. The bar that you want to benchmark is going to be the bar of the 29th of May, of January, rather. That's the bar that you want to benchmark out there. Let's go take, that's Lam Research. NVDA, we look at NVIDIA out here. NVIDIA, the low for the year is 180, the high is 614. Man, this is pretty intense spread, no doubt about that. And we take a look at this one. Let's put this on a weekly also. Monster consolidation again. Yeah, I'd let it go to the bottom of the consolidation. The bottom of the consolidation, when you're in a consolidation, is where it's at. You know, that's the real bottom line. No pun. But that's, let this get down to 468. Right now you're at 512. TSCO, let's see what we have here. This is Tractor Supply. The low is 64, the high is 174. Put this on a weekly. Okay, so this one's a beauty, man. Okay. If you're a long-term trader, man, this is an ABC up, and it's a monster, too. So your B point is 155. Your A point is 63. How cool is that? Oh, my God. So we're talking, you get 37, what did I say? 40, 55, 65, 75, 85, 93. You're talking 200. It's an ABC structure up to 200. Broke the B point, has it with volume, did it again yesterday. You're at 169. Yeah, you get an ABC up. Let's take a look at this. This is another one that, guess what? Commodities, where it's at. Revenue-wise, what they're looking for. The next time they come out with numbers, they're going to be on the 23rd of April. They're looking to do $10.9 billion this year, and they're going to bring $6.74 to the bottom line. And for a large company, it's pretty amazing that they're still growing by 13.5%. Big numbers. When you break it down, the livestock and pets are $5 billion. Hardware is $2.2. Seasonal is $2.2. Clothing is $700 million. And agriculture is $424. So Tractor Supply is off to the races, man. Yeah, there's no doubt about that. And it is in an ABC structure up already. Let's go over to the Qs, because we've been talking about the ABC structure on the way up. Bottom line, had it, gave it up, had it, gave it up. Now you're giving it up again. You're at 314. You're going to, the 311.39 out here today is going to be really important. The 311.39 was the low that was established out here Monday. 311.39? Oh, yeah, we're not going to hit that. We've only hit 312 so far. Okay, so if you look at, let's say tomorrow, 311.39 is the number that you want to keep your eye on. That was the low that was established Monday. That's where we rejected lower price. That is also the highs of the lows, which is the 312.04. And it's going to be hard to basically break that baby down. We look at this intraday again. And what you have here, intraday is that you're down 884, you're testing the lows. We get a question about the nothing more bearish than a failed bullish structure. Is that correct? But that's not an ABC structure. I've seen plenty of complex ABC structures, and that is a complex one. So this is a great question, number one, okay? And he is correct, that when you have a failed bullish or a failed bearish, And it's a structure that fails, you can go the other way very quickly. That being said, this is not a failed, well, we could say it's a failed ABC structure, but it's a complex one. And this is what the difference is. The difference on a complex one is that as you're pulling back, you once again pull back with lighter volume. And if that's what you get, what ends up happening there, that is basically pulling back, and you are pulling back with lighter volume. Let's get a Bill in Boston. Hey, Bill, what's going on?
What's up, Tom? I want your opinion on QFIN. I want you to tell me if it's a big ABC up.
Let's take a look at it. You get QFIN, 360 Digital Tech, the low's 637, the high's 35. Let's see what they do here. They provide a finance platform, and they're in the banking business. I see it's a fintech banking company. They're taking a lot of money. Holy cow. They're taking $13.6 billion. They make $28 to the bottom line. Man, this is a trip. Okay, you got action here, man. And, yes, you have an ABC structure up, man. Your B point on this is 33. Your A point is 19. You're talking about $14. Your C point out here is 28, 38, 44 bucks, man.
That's what I thought.
You got action, man.
What about a longer term? Anything even bigger on a longer term?
Let's take a look at this. I'll put it on a monthly. I think it's going to be too new. Yeah, it's too new.
Okay.
That's quite a company, man. I mean, let me just. So this went public. Where'd it go? I see. Okay, so it went public December 2018. $16, you're at 34. Yeah, I mean, the bottom, yeah, you get action, man. You could You definitely get action. Cooking, brother.
All right, thanks, Malcolm.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Let's go take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here. And this market continues to sell off, folks. You got AMC is flat out here. You got GE's down 37 cents. You got American Airlines off $3. We got Plug Power down $2. Tesla's down 42. You got Microsoft down $6.50. Let's go over to Microsoft. That no doubt is a big dog inside of all the indices. Microsoft right now, yeah, you're pulling back with light volume. Microsoft just wants to go to the other end of consolidation. Consolidation there is 224, you're at 230. Let's see where Amazon is, because Amazon's been in this consolidation for a long time. It's pulling back with light volume too. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Hi, folks, this is Tom O'Brien. The printing presses are working 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. The U.S. deficit has risen 200% in 1 year with no end in sight. The markets are looking for an additional stimulus bill to get us through this once-in-a-generation pandemic. There is no free lunch, folks. The more stimulus dollars put into the marketplace, the less your dollar is worth each and every day. This is the time to protect yourself with a portion of your portfolio in the metal market. The Gold Report comes out each Monday morning. I bisect and dissect the dollar, silver, gold, the XAU, and the HUI. The Gold Report is a long-term hedge against the dilution of your buying power. The U.S. has put more than $6 trillion into the marketplace in the last 6 months, with more expected in the next few months. The market did and does need the stimulus, but it will have long-term implications on our buying power. The Gold Report comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Go to TFNN.com and order the Gold Report now. Protect your buying power. Order the Gold Report now.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den trading room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hey, welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 54. You get the Nasdaq off 337. S&Ps are off 44. And we go and take a look. Let's get over to Amazon. I'm going to take a look at a couple of these FANG stocks out here. So you get Amazon down $91, folks. You know, what Amazon has already done, and this is where you want to watch the highs of the lows on Amazon, is going to be 3,009. 3,009 was the highs of the lows. That's what was basically testing this lower end of the consolidation that it's been in for, let's see how long we've been in here. Oh, a long time, man. Holy cow. Yeah, this consolidation started July of 2020. So just about, well, it'll be a year and a few months. Bottom line, we'll see how this shakes out. It does look, yeah, it actually does look to me like this thing can test the lows again. That's how this is shaking out. You know, you get, it rejected the lows last time we were down there on a weekly with 20 million versus 28. Yeah, we'll see if that's going to basically go after that test once again. Netflix, we go take a look at Netflix out here. Netflix right now is trading down $17. This has a big contraction of volume. You know, it can go test the lower end, which is 492, but you're talking about a monster contraction volume out here. After the close out here, we're going to have FedEx come out with numbers, FDX. FedEx right now, low for the year is 89, the high is 305. You're trading 265. Let's see what they're saying, how they are going to be, let's see, they want to come in with $20 billion. Top line, $3.22 to the bottom line. We take a look at this equity. Still got a consolidation in place. I don't see a lot of movement on this equity when they come out with their numbers. Nike also going to be coming out with those numbers after the close. The low for the year is 60. The high is 147. That's trading 43 right now. Nike's going to look to come in with $11 billion to the top line, 75 cents to the bottom line. And it's amazing that company, well, it's still growing by 3.5%. Now, this equity, this is going to get interesting because this has been up at these highs for a while. You have, yeah, this is good. So Nike, folks, okay, Nike has been on a run for a long period of time. That being said, it doesn't look to me like Nike's going to blow out its numbers. And the reason being is this, is that you can see 3 weeks ago, we came down with some juice. We came down with 38 million. We went back topside last week with 25 million. Right now you have 22, which is not bad, but not great. But you see the correlation. The correlation is the 22 versus the 38 with 1 day left. And on top of that, yeah, it hasn't failed on price yet. It's very close, though. That's telling me that Nike's going to stay in a consolidation. So, and Nike basically just finishes off earnings season. But the way earnings season does work, folks, it seems like it just winds itself right back up. Now, when we talk in earnings season, let's go back to the banks, because the banks, folks, and this is why you see the Dow Industrials, you know, down 90 now, but that's why you see in the banks strong. These banks are in ABC structures on the way up. J.P. Morgan taking a B point out, taking it out with volume. Let me see if we get this on a weekly also. You don't have it on a weekly. On the dailies, they're there. They're small ones, but the bottom line is they're saying they want to go to a higher price. I bring this back. Let me do this way. You got, let's see, 146. Well, you get 11 bucks, which gets you 163. And J.P. Morgan, you're at 157. Bank of America, BAC, same setup. BAC is a clean one, actually, real clean. The B point on BAC is 38. It's only $4, though. Still gets you $40.50. So, and of course, with that, it's all about, that is about those interest rates. The TLT, this is the 20-year bond plus TLT out here, this is going to get interesting because the TLT hit the 133.19 today, did reject lower price. They're buying the TLT. And what you do have, like, this has been a one-way shot on the way down. No two ways about that, just straight down. Last time we had volume on the way down was 136.61. And when you're taking a look at this, folks, okay, this is what ends up happening. Markets always get overbought, oversold in a huge way. Gold market in particular, I mean, forget it. You know, you go to the moon, you go to, then you go to freaking hell. Bottom line, TLT, kind of the same thing. You know, bottom line, that being said, you know, 136.61 is a big number, meaning that's the last time that we had big sellers in there. Couldn't hold price, couldn't sustain price, but that's a start to basically get a trend going. The real kicker is going to be is that just a counter trend bounce, or in fact, are you going to see the note and bond market go to higher price once again? There's no doubt that you have many, you have huge amounts of shots inside the market. You have huge amounts of big dudes pushing, well, they're pushing their trades, they're pushing their books in the market that, you know, that the interest rate structure is going to get ahead of the Fed. I don't buy it, man. Guess what? When you were the Federal Reserve, folks, and you have unlimited printing ability, no one gets ahead of the Fed. That's the bottom line, okay? The Fed controls the short end of the curve. Ray Dalio out here, he's out here right now saying inflation can force the Federal Reserve to raise rates earlier than anticipated. That whole story's been out there, you know, for weeks at a time. And listen, there's plenty of high caliber people that have done very well saying the exact same thing. What I don't quite get out of that is the aspect of that they know just as well that, guess what? The Fed has unlimited firepower on the short end, not on the long end. Let's go to our man Jose in Lakeland. Jose, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom. Tom, a couple weeks ago, you gave a very passionate talk about boosting gold. You sounded like Clarence Darrow in the courtroom giving his final summation, conviction and a love for gold. So is Newmont ready to buy, or AEM? I mean, you got Whipsaw Friday tomorrow, don't you, with gold?
Yeah, you do.
Okay, so can these pull back?
Yeah, they can. I mean, Newmont's been on a good run. I mean, in 2 weeks, it just went from, you know, what, 54 to 62. If we go to an Eco Eagle, that's gone sideways. It was a good day yesterday. I mean, if you're looking for one of these, what I would do is this. Because the Newmont really ran so much, I'd bite on an Eco Eagle. And the reason being, Jose, is that this, the way this traded yesterday, this is an ABC up. So 60 is a B, 54.
We're
so it's a 5.8. It's a 5.8 ABB, which would give us $63.59. And you're at 60.15.
So, I gotcha. Okay. What do you think's coming tomorrow? Whipsaw Friday for gold down?
No, I think it's... I like how... Yeah, stay right there. Stay right there. We'll come right back.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 142. You get the NASDAQ off 378. S&Ps are off 55. We're talking to Jose. We're talking about gold. And we're particularly talking about gold, folks, because the bottom line is that coming into a Friday is always a danger inside of the gold market. Now, that being said, Jose, I really like how the gold contract's pushing into the swing point with volume. We've got a monster expansion of volume out here today, which is 244,000.
Yeah.
That's a good setup. Now, that you're going to kill me here, but that being said, the dollar is still not cooperating here, man. You know?
Yeah.
So what I would do is this. I wouldn't put the trade on right now, man. I'd wait for the morning. Because
you're saying tomorrow morning, see where gold shakes out?
I would. You know,
I wasn't going to do it until tomorrow anyway. But, Tom, the gold stocks, the techs are getting annihilated. What is the relationship with this scare, with this 2% on the 10-year? Is it because when the yield is climbing over 2%, is that because growth stocks go down because it's competing? It's the 2% is competing against stocks. What's going on?
Supposedly,
there?
Yeah. I mean, the mantra has always been that, you know, gold doesn't pay an interest. If interest rates go higher, bottom line is gold's going to go lower. That being said, guess what? At 1.7 or 2%, you know, that to me, I mean, you're still at 0% rates on a, you know, so
yeah,
I don't buy it. I don't buy that deal at all. You know what I mean? So, but
well, we all knew Powell was going to be being the worst Fed chairman ever. We knew he was going to talk dovish with the, you know, no interest rates for the next 100 years. I mean,
I think you know, I would say, and you know, I think I know you've heard me say this, you know. Bernie Sanders, okay, has to be pulling his hair out, not now. But the reality is that what he projected, you know, during his campaign, we're already in. We're in. My take is that we're in this modern monetary theory. And what modern monetary theory is, folks, is this, is that you're pushing out stimulus payments to the public. And what ends up happening is that the public turns around, spends the money, gets the cash flow going. And it looks to me like that we're in it, and I don't think we're going to be getting out of it, man.
Yeah. Tom, remember back in 06, 07, the big leak, the memo by Citibank, where they said we're living in a plutonomy. The biggest fear they had was one person, one vote. That would be the end of capitalism, because we're living in a plutonomy where 92% of our 98% of the households own, or the top 2% own more than the 98% below.
Is that what a plot? Is that what
that? Plutonomy, I guess, is when the least amount of households, 2%ers, own as much as the 98% underneath.
Which is not good. That's pure BS.
Which is not good. But Tom, you're familiar with the PPP, the payment, the payroll protection plan?
Yes.
In your opinion, isn't that socialism or no?
Yeah, that's my point. That's my point. Well, I don't know if it's socialism, but
of it in the first 6 months.
But that's my point. That I think we're already there, and guess what? No one says no. Okay,
right.
I think we're already there. And so if we're there, like people always worry about, okay, how's the debt going to get paid back? Well, why is it ever going to get paid back? It's just going to keep rolling. It's rolled all our lives, man. What makes it think it's going to be any different? You know, you roll it out. Another 30 years, you roll it out another 50 years. I don't see it. That's where I think we're at, man. So.
Yeah, I do. Tom, I sneezed inside a public supermarket. They're coming after me with pitchforks. I got to go.
They should be. Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. And, you know, for all you folks, particularly up in the Boston area, this is a sad story. If you've ever been to the Boston Marathon, have been into sports, I forget the guy's name, his son's name is Rick, but there's a man, folks, that was always racing with his son, and this started about 35 years ago, and he passed away yesterday. So send some great white light and some prayers to that family, because if you ever saw the dedication that this family had, it was phenomenal. I was lucky enough to see them at the beginning of the run in the 80s, and just really cool and just amazing. So his son was a quadriplegic, and this guy ran like 1,000 marathons, man. It was so freaking cool. It was insane. Let's go to Art in Orlando. Hey, Art, what's going on?
Good afternoon, Tom. How's the grandbaby doing?
Oh, he's doing great, man. Here, in fact, hold on. Wait till you see this. This is so cool, folks. Watch this. He looks just like Popeye. This is, here, you got to see this. Can you see this picture? Look at him. Look at him. Look at his wink.
Not coming up yet. We're watching you on YouTube.
Here, 1 second. There he is. There he is.
Oh, that's great.
He's a beauty.
Good for you.
Thank you.
I'm calling for a family member who has a question about Enphase. She was in it and made some money and got out of it, looking at the pullback and wondering what a possible buy point might be. And I had a related question. Can you see who the recent sellers have been through your Bloomberg connection?
Yes, absolutely. Let's take a look at it. It's Enphase. It's a manufacturer of solar power solutions. The low is $21. The high is $229. Okay, so put this on. Okay, so I wouldn't be buying it right here. This got a lot, you know, this already, it had a high, 222. That was generated January this year. Then it tested that high and it failed on price and volume. It goes from 222 to 131. I'd let this get back down to the 128, man. And you got to be careful at this level. Let me just look at this for a second. So revenue-wise, $1.3 billion. Yeah, they're making $2. That's good. They're making energy. They're making money. But that has, because it went up so dramatically, that can pull back and pull back pretty good. Buyers, let's take a look. So 220, February 28th, you get it. That's Alliance Bank. They're in there. March 17th, that's First Trust Advisors. They were buying yesterday. Let me see who's selling. Oh, no, that's 2021. Well, you get Renaissance Talk. No, right there. Goldberg Capital selling, February 23rd. Here's another one. SunPower, interesting. SunPower is selling, too. You got to be careful with SunPower, because SunPower owns 5.5 million shares. They own 4.26% of it, and they're selling, man.
Yeah, that's...
Oh, no, hold it. I'm sorry, hold it. No, that's 20... What, let me pull this up. That looks like 2020, not 2021. Yeah, no, that's all right. No, that's 2020, man. So I'd still wait for the pullback, brother.
Okay, thanks so much, John.
Have a great one, man. Have a safe one. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Folks, Dow Industrials right now down 138 to get the Nasdaq off 400, S&P's off 57. And, you know, we were just talking about interest rates there with Jose. And inside the oil market, I just want to show you something that gets so skewed, it's unbelievable. So, you know, I love Bloomberg, okay? They got some great writers, but there's a writer out here right now that is saying the strong dollar is what took oil south. And it's like, give me a break, man. I mean, oil doesn't get down $5, folks, okay, on a strong dollar, and we've been up there. We're down $5.82. That is a supply issue, man, in an extraordinary way. So be careful of, the bottom line, you can read all the articles, of course, but just simultaneously keep your mind open, because that is like skewed beyond belief that this dollar has been laying out here forever. Let's get over and take a look at the market in general. We take a look at the SPY first. What you're going to have, we're down 59 points inside the S&P. You're down with 93 million. You're coming into option expiration, so it's going to be a nice option expiration, folks, okay? Nothing like a good pullback into option expiration. Bring up the volatility inside the marketplace. And the NQs, same type of setup in the NQs. NQs down 975, haven't caught a bid all day long. That being said, you are going into that 311.39. We hit 311.57. That's the number that it's going after. That was the low that was established out here on Monday. And the number to keep an eye on tomorrow morning, folks, is going to be 312.04. 312, we're right at it, too. I love it. 312.04 is the number, folks. And what that is the highs of the lows that were generated out here on the 4th. Because when you have a high-volume low, and the high of that low, it's very hard to crack that down. That's going to be $139 million. You're coming into that with $72 million. So that is going to be some nice support right there. We'll see whether it can hold. That's the real bottom line. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step inside it. Take ownership of it. Fly with it. Everything you need is right inside you, folks. You might as well have a blast with it. Come back and visit us tomorrow. Peace, tell your friends about TFNN. Tell them to go to YouTube and subscribe. It is free. Bam! Look at them, folks.